Thank you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. At that time, Jesus spoke to the Pharisees, saying, I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. The Pharisees then said to him, you are bearing witness to yourself. Your testimony is not true. Jesus answered, even if I do bear witness to myself, my testimony is true. For I know where I come from and where I am going. But you do not know where I come from or where I am going. You judge according to the flesh, I judge no one. Yet even if I do judge, my judgment is true. For it is not I alone that judge, but I am he who sent me. In your law it is written that the testimony of two men is true. I bear witness to myself, and the Father who sent me bears witness to me. They said to him, therefore, where is your Father? Jesus answered, you know neither me nor my Father. If you knew me, you would know my Father also. These words he spoke in the treasury, as he taught in the temple. But no one arrested him, because his hour had not yet come. The Gospel of the Lord. Saint Benedict was the son of African slaves, owned by a rich family in Sicily. Set free as a child, even as a youth, Benedict attracted attention. For his patience and his charity, once, as he was being taught to account his colour, a passing Franciscan noticed him and invited him to join his community of hermits. Benedict did this. Eventually, in light of his evident holiness, he was chosen to serve as superior of the community. In time, this informed group was directed by the Pope to affiliate with a regular order, and so they joined the order of Friars Minor, the Franciscans. Benedict was accepted as a lay brother and put to work as a cook. Once again, however, his special gifts drew wonder and respect. Though he was illiterate, he had an extraordinary knowledge of scripture and theology, and his gift for reading souls put him in great demand as a spiritual director. Eventually his fame became a form of penance, as the sick flocked to him for healing, and pilgrims of every station sought his counsel. Benedict died in the year 1589 at the age of 63. He was canonized in 1807. Apart from widespread veneration in Latin America, Saint Benedict was claimed as a patron saint of African Americans, and is also in a special way one of our patron saints of the Franciscans in South Africa, and that's why we're celebrated today as a feast day. And when I was living in Sicily, speak spirit in this space. The Lord is our shepherd. There is nothing we shall lack. Let us place before him our own needs and those of the world. Let us pray for those ensnared by a life of crime from which they cannot escape. Lord, hear us. Let us pray for those whose lives are ruled by unfavorable publicity or notoriety. Lord, hear us. Let us pray that we may be slow to criticize others and never hasty in our judgment. Lord, hear us. Let us pray that in our very darkness, we will feel the presence of God. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Father, be with us as we prepare for the Easter festival. Listen to our prayers, those spoken out loud, those in the silence of our hearts, and grant all we ask through Jesus Christ.
Blessed are you, O God, O creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread of you, fruit of the earth, and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine of our food, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual food.
Thank you.
The love of you. Remember all the church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and with him our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, before us speak in the hope of the resurrection, and all who die in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph of Spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, the Saint David the Grand, and all the saints of these who are the angels, we may merit eternal days to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. insert it into my heart. I embrace it as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never let me to be separated from you. Amen. Said.